Hello everyone and welcome to the course of Mechanical System Design, in which we are starting with a new unit, that is design of IC engine components. We will start with design of cylinder. IC engine is a mechanical device which converts chemical energy of the fuel into thermal energy by combustion of the fuel. It converts thermal energy into mechanical work through a slider crank mechanism, which is the basis of design of IC engine. The construction of IC engine is as shown in this figure. It consists of a cylinder in which the piston reciprocates. The reciprocating motion of piston is converted into rotary motion of a crank by a connecting rod. The connecting rod is connected to the piston at the small end using the gudgeon pin. The big end of the connecting rod is connected to the crankshaft by a crank pin. The main pin of a crankshaft is mounted inside the block of an engine. The cylinder has to be extended downwards to cover the connecting rod and the crankshaft. The cylinder along with its extension in total is called as block or the crankcase, which is the biggest part of an engine. From top it is covered with the help of a cylinder head. Cylinder head has several important parts such as passages for the flow of the gases in and out of the cylinder. It also contains wall train, which is used for controlling the flow of the gases. From the bottom, the block is closed with the help of an oil sump, which contains oil for the lubrication. Thus, the most important parts of an IC engine are cylinder head, cylinder, piston, connecting rod, and crankshaft. All these parts are designed against the maximum gas pressure in the combustion chamber of an engine. Let us start with the design of cylinder. Its function is to contain the working fluid and guide the piston. Thus, it has got some desirable properties such as it should be strong enough to withstand the gas pressure. It should be hard enough so that to resist the wear due to the rubbing friction of a piston. It should be corrosion resistant and it should have good bearing properties. Thus, gray cast iron and alloy cast iron are the most popular materials used for the cylinder design. The inner surface of the cylinder is heat treated to harden it and improve its wear resistance. The construction of a cylinder depends upon type of cooling arrangement. If it is an air-cooled engine, fins are provided which requires thinner walls of a cylinder. If it is a water-cooled engine, then water jacket has to be provided, which are basically passages for the flow of water. And due to the presence of water jacket, the thickness of the wall of the cylinder will be higher. Another aspect which governs the design is whether the cylinder is having parent bore or cylinder liner. In case of parent bore, this cylinder drilled into the block itself is the cylinder of an engine, whereas in case of cylinder liner type of design, the cylinder drilled there is a cylinder liner as shown in this figure, which is inserted into the bore drilled into the block. Thus, it can be imagined that all the stresses due to the pressure are experienced by the cylinder liner and not by the block. The advantages of cylinder liner design is the liners are easy to replace if something goes wrong with the cylinder or liner. It can be made up of a better material since it has to withstand higher pressure, and rest of the block can be made from the cheaper material, which results in overall cheaper design. Moreover, these are freely suspended inside the cylinder, hence the cylinder liner perform better in case of longitudinal thermal expansion. Cylinder liners are of two types, wet and dry liner. When the cooling water is directly in contact with the liner, it is called as wet liner, and when the water jacket is not directly contacted by the liner, it is called as dry liner. The difference between these two is mentioned in this table based on four parameters, in which wet liners are easy to manufacture and are effective in cooling since they are in direct contact with the water. But for the same reason, there are chances of leakage in case of wet liner, and it makes replacement of a liner difficult as compared to the dry liner. The most important calculation is calculation of maximum gas pressure or peak pressure, since against it all the components of an IC engine are designed. At the start of the design, brake power and the corresponding speed of the engine are known to the designer. Moreover, the displacement or swept volume of the engine is also known. With the help of these three parameters, the design will start. With the known value of mechanical efficiency, or by assuming it to be approximately 80%, and known value of brake power, indicated power is calculated. It is given by this well-known formula PMLAN upon 60 into 1000. Various terms in this formula are interpreted over here. It should be noted that N is not the speed of the engine, but it is cycles per minute. So for a 4-stroke engine, it is half of the speed, and for 2-stroke engine, it is equal to speed of the engine. L into A together will give you the value of swept volume. With known swept volume, corresponding maximum speed of the engine and IP, mean effective pressure can be calculated. By multiplying mean effective pressure by the factor of 10, maximum pressure, that is peak pressure, can be calculated. And with this, the design will start. Another important calculation is swept volume can be given by L into pi by 4 D square. For a known value, infinite combination of stroke and diameter are present. In this formula, these two are unknown, whereas only one equation is available. So we have to express stroke and bore in terms of each other to solve this problem. Either bore is considered higher than stroke to call it as an over square engine, or it is equal to stroke, or bore is considered smaller than stroke, and then this problem of calculation of bore and stroke can be solved. Various stresses are experienced by the cylinder, such as circumferential, longitudinal and radial stresses. They are quite similar to the stresses studied in the design of pressure vessels. Resultant stress is given by sigma r equal to sigma c minus nu into sigma r plus sigma l, where nu is the Poisson's ratio of the material. Thickness of a cylinder can be calculated by applying principal stress theory, which states that the material will fail if the principal stress in the material exceeds the allowable stress. Out of these three stresses, circumferential stress is the most critical and the principal stress. So the formula is used to calculate the formula of thickness. Here sigma allowable is the allowable stress given by yield strength or ultimate tensile strength divided by factor of safety plus C1. C1 is the reboring allowance. Over the period of time, the bore is subjected to wear, and if it is non-uniform in nature, it will result in leakage of gases through the gaps created between piston and cylinder. So it has to be reboard. It will result in slight increase in the internal diameter, but more dangerously, it results in the reduction in thickness. To always maintain the allowable thickness or the calculated thickness in the wall of the cylinder, this reboring allowance is added into the formula of the thickness. Here are guidelines for applying reboring allowance for the given bore diameter. Let us solve a numerical example to understand this concept. Design the cylinder of a 4-stroke diesel engine having following specification. You may pause the video to go through the given data. The thickness can be calculated by this formula, which we have already discussed. Allowable stress can be calculated by ultimate tensile strength upon factor of safety. By putting all the known values, we will get thickness equal to 11.34 mm, which is rounded off to 12 mm. Although the design of thickness is obtained, it is important to calculate all the values of stresses. Thus, circumferential, longitudinal, radial and resultant stresses are calculated. And it is ensured that values of all these stresses is less than the allowable stress of the material, which is 200 divided by 5 equal to 40. Thus we can say that the design thickness 12 mm is safe in the given problem. Thus we can design the cylinder of an IC engine. In the next lecture, we will see design of the cylinder head.